नमस्ते, कैसे हैं आप और कैसा चल रहा है आपका क्वारंटीन स्लैश लॉकडाउन। तो आज हम बहुत ही स्पेशल रीजन के लिए मिल रहे हैं, बिकॉज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाट आर द फूड्स दैट यू कैन ईट एंड इंक्लूड इन योर डाइट सो दैट यू नो लॉन्गर हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ पीरियड पेन। आजकल यू नो एटलीस्ट वन इन एवरी थ्री गर्ल्स इज हैविंग पीसीओडी। होल लॉट ऑफ अस हैव पीरियड ट्रबल, पीएमएस प्रॉब्लम्स एंड स्टफ लाइक दैट। देर इज अ राइज इन एंडोमेट्रियोसिस, एडिनोमायोसिस एंड स्टफ, बट इट नीड नॉट बी लाइक दैट। ऑल दैट वी नीड टू डू इज मेक अ रिटर्न टू ईटिंग आर टाइम टेस्टेड ट्रेडिशनल नेटिव फूड्स। सो हियर्स मी थ्रोइंग सम लाइट ऑन व्हाट आर द थिंग्स दैट यू कैन इंक्लूड इन योर डाइट, एंड दीज आर द फूड्स दैट यू शुड बी ईटिंग रूटीनली, but surely eating at least 10 days before your periods. For all those of you who are unable to tell कि उनका period कब होने वाला है, तो जब भी आपको symptoms चालू हो जाए आपके PMS के, cramps, migraine, nausea and stuff, तब से ये plan आप चालू करो. All right? Now stay with me. This is going to be a masterclass. You're going to love this. And when you follow it, it's going to work like wonders. All right, number one thing. Seeds. What are the kind of seeds that you should be eating if you have any kind of PCOD and stuff? अभी बहुत सारे seeds हैं जो कि आजकल बहुत popular हो गए हैं, जैसे सब्जा seeds हैं and stuff like that. But not everyone can have it. Okay? So if you have PCOD, then you can have. Oh, my pen doesn't work. देखो मेरा pen नहीं चल रहा है और लॉकडाउन अभी भी चालू है, तो मैं कैसा अभी नया पेन लेके आऊं। आई होप के जब खुलेगा तो आई विल बाय माई सेल्फ अ न्यू पेन। ओके, सो यू कैन हैव सब्जा। इफ यू हैव एंडोमेट्रियोसिस देन नो सब्जा। ओके, आप सब्जा नहीं ले सकते हो, लेकिन फिर आपको क्या लेना चाहिए? गोंद, दैट्स सैपोनिन एंड स्टफ। हम लोग जो बोलते हैं जो कि गोंद के लड्डू बनते हैं पोस्ट पार्टम वुमेन के लिए, दैट्स द गोंद दैट यू कैन हैव। हाउ कैन यू हैव इट? यू जस्ट हीट इट इन वाटर, यू कैन ऐड अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ शुगर, अलाउ दैट टू कूल डाउन, पुट अ टीस्पून ऑफ घी एंड देन सिप ऑन इट। दिस इज एस्पेशली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल दोज वुमेन हु हैव एंडलेस ब्लीडिंग। ये आपको पेरीमेनोपॉजल के टाइम पे भी काम आएगा, जब आप जस्ट खड़े हो एंड ऑल ऑफ अ सडन यू हैव अ रश ऑफ ब्लड एंड यू डोंट नो व्हाट टू डू, तो आप गोंद का लड्डू ले सकते हो। इफ यू हैव दिस द एडिनोमायोसिस थिंग, यू कैन हैव सब्जा, बट यू विल हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल। इट विल जस्ट नीड टू बी लाइक अ पिंच ऑफ सब्जा, नो मोर देन दैट। ऑलराइट, बट व्हाट यू कैन हैव इज आरिफ। आरिफ इज समथिंग विच यू कैन ऑल्सो हैव इन पीसीओडी। तो पीसीओडी में आप सब्जा ले सकते हो, आप आरिफ ले सकते हो। एंडो में आप सब्जा नहीं ले सकते हो, आप गोन ले सकते हो। एडिनोमायोसिस में आप आरिफ ले सकते हो, बट फॉर नॉट मोर देन 3 days इन अ मंथ। ओके, सो मेक श्योर दैट यू आर नॉट हैविंग इट फॉर मोर देन 3 days इन अ मंथ। Here you can have it all the 10 days. यहाँ पर सब्जा या आरिफ को आप टच मत करो, यू स्टे विद गोंद। सो दैट्स समथिंग दैट यू मस्ट रिमेंबर। द सेकेंड थिंग इज लेग्यूम्स। लेग्यूम्स या आप उसको पल्सेस भी बोल सकते हो, जैसे कि अरसाने है गोवा के साइड का, देर इज नवरंगी दाल, देर इज कुड़त या कुल्थी विच इज अक्रॉस इंडिया, देर इज राजमा, चना, लोबिया, चौली, मूंग, मटकी, वाल, तुअर, अरहर, बहुत सारे हैं। कल ही मैंने मेरे किचन में काउंट किया तो मेरे पास करंटली अभी 15 है। मूंग के भी मेरे पास 3 वैरायटी है, ग्रीन, ब्लैक एंड अ लिटिल येलोइश। तो बहुत सारी वैरायटीज में इन्वेस्ट करो एंड ऑल ऑफ अस कैन हैव लेग्यूम्स। ठीक है, ईच वन ऑफ अस शुड हैव दीज लेग्यूम्स। आप इन लेग्यूम्स को कैसे खा सकते हो? सो वन ऑफ द बेस्ट वेज ऑफ ईटिंग दीज लेग्यूम्स इज टू हैव देम विद दही एंड राइस। स्पेशली ये पीसीओडी के टाइम पे या हर एक कंडीशन के टाइम पे, पीएमएस कैन गेट वेरी वेरी ट्रबलसम एंड देन समटाइम्स वी मे लूज एपेटाइट बट वी आर स्टिल हंग्री। सो द बेस्ट वे टू ईट इट इज टू हैव दही राइस फॉर लंच and then make like a little sukha or a patla thing with the legumes and then have dahi rice and then that legume. So some of the legumes which are you know, if I had to pick up which is the best legume, though all legumes are good, I would say moong here. Okay, M-O-O-N-G, moong. I would say red chauli here. Alright. And for PCOD and stuff, though again, one more time, all legumes are good. But if you have endo, make sure that you're having moong. If you have adenomyosis, have the red chauli. And here, you can have kurith. Now remember, kurith can also be, like a whole lot of people say, heaty. So what you then need to do is eat it with dahi rice, taake uska it is more cooling. You can also make a karan out of it, which is where you make it with buttermilk or dahi. You can find its recipe on my mother's Instagram page. So this is what you can do. Okay, one more very, very important thing. Invariably during our PMS, or you know, when we are feeling dull and low or have any one of these conditions, we feel like eating something that is fried. Now when you do feel like eating something that is fried, don't get chips from outside, don't call for burgers and likes. What you must do when you feel like eating something which is fried is make yourself legumes ka bhaji and make them at home, and these can then become a part of your lunch or they can become a part of your dinner. Like you could just have a moong dal khichdi with the legume ka bhaji. What kind of legumes turn into bhaji? Urad dal bhajiya, moong dal bhajiya, or even moong dal ka papad. You know, so we make legumes ke fried things which are either papad or bhajiya at home. Have those kind of things when you feel like eating something fried. That way you're eating something which is healthy, which is rich in protein and rich in fiber, and it will not trouble you or make you fat. Millets, it's very critical to eat millets in all of these conditions. And nachni, jawar, these are something that you can have at all points of time. But if you have any of these two conditions, then what you must also include in your diet is rajgira. Okay, rajgira or kuttu. Yep, yahan pe PCOD mein bhi kha sakte ho. But how can you have rajgira and kuttu? You can have it for breakfast, like rajgira ka laddu and a cup of milk. Or you can have rajgira thale peet. Or you could have like a kuttu ki roti. Any of these things at all. Here you can like safely have nachni, again nachni porridge, nachni dosa. You could have these here too. Okay. Alright. Fruit. Now it's very important to eat fruits and eat the right quality of fruits. So PCOD mein you can have everything. The banana, mango, sitafal, jackfruit, grapes. Anything that is in season. For all three conditions, ensure that you are having a fresh fruit. For all those of you who have migraine, start your day with a banana. And migraine does, you know, you will have lesser intensity and frequency of migraine, if not a complete freedom from migraine. So make sure that you're having a, you know, banana is good for everyone. The thing to remember with banana is that in all of these conditions, it's important to eat banana in all of its forms. Matlab banana flower of zarur khaiye, especially if you're PCOD and are trying to get pregnant, then the banana flower is something that you should be eating. Kacha banane ka bhaji bhi at least, you know, in all of these conditions, 2 to 3 times a month is when you should be eating. At least once should be during PMS. You can even eat banana ka atta, you know, the post that I made a couple of days ago. So make sure that you are eating the banana, because then it will just kind of help you regulate all of your hormones, especially the ones on PCOD and who are taking oral contraceptive pills, you know. So make sure that you are eating that kacha banana. Kacha banana ka chips bhi aap kha sakte ho. Jaise ki maine aapko bola ke, when you're feeling like eating something fried, choose a better fried. So just like how you can make bhajiya out of dal, you can even have it out of kacha banana. Ghar par bana ke khao. Now the most important and game changer in this entire scenario, as far as our reproductive system goes, are root vegetables and tubers. They are also the most underutilized foods or nutrients really when it comes to dealing with these conditions. Most people, when they have either PCOD or endo and stuff, also seem to have a problem of their body weight or obesity, so they tend to avoid these vegetables. But it is exactly these vegetables and their compounds which even make the base of most prescription drugs that you take when you have these kind of conditions. Root vegetables like the suran, the arbi, the sweet potato, there are many, you know, I don't even have names for this. I got this one from Sona, it's called the konfer. Okay, aap agar dekhoge to aapko isme beautiful purple color bhi dikhai dega. See, so beautiful to look at. So this is konfer. So konfer ho gaya, jo bhi aapke region ka hai, at least one such vegetable every week, but surely for 4 days at a stretch when you have your PMS. All right, isme aap aloo ka bhi addition kar sakte ho, but it cannot be just aloo, so it will have to be sweet potato, arbi, suran, konfer, all of these roots and tubers of your region. This is something that human beings have consumed for centuries, and what we now know is that they have phenolic compounds, they have antioxidant activity, they are prebiotic in nature. Prebiotic matlab they help you improve your digestion. So jisko bhi bloating hota hai, constipation hota hai, acidity hota hai during this time, all that you need are root vegetables and tubers in your diet. So if it's endo, surely the sweet potato. Adeno, the suran. Okay, here all of them, but also the micro ones, the stuff that doesn't really have a name in English. I'm writing kacha banana also here. So along with all of the root vegetables, have the kacha banana also. So this is extremely important, because if you have this, then over a period of time you will not need medication, you will not need painkillers and stuff like that, because you will be able to support your system just with the help of a wholesome diet. All right, remember, we are right now also doing the EASE PMS study, where these are the guidelines that we have given out. Soaked raisins and kesar, both soaked separately but soaked overnight and had first thing in the morning, at least 10 days prior to your periods, and we are seeing excellent results. With all these things, what we see is lesser cramps, lesser back pain, lesser breast tenderness, lesser irritability, lesser mood swings. Ghee to your diet, so that is something which stays, 1 teaspoon of ghee for, you know, in every meal, breakfast, lunch and dinner, and a banana once every day, so like between 4 and 6 in the evening. And so yeah, these are the things that you can be eating. For more details, the 12 week fitness project, you know, do read the book. I think all the deliveries have also started, book deliveries, so you can lay your hands on this book and buy it. And yeah, this is how you should be eating. We will publish a proper document, and over a period of time, maybe even like a framework of a meal plan, so that you know exactly how to go about eating. Remember that hormones are based on the food that you eat. If you deprive yourself of food based on carbohydrate, protein, fat, if you deprive yourself of food based on abhi 16 ghanta nahi hua, abhi 18 ghanta nahi hua, if you deprive yourself food on based on I just shouldn't be eating this and stuff like that, you will never really strike a proper hormonal balance. In fact, just yesterday I learned something very interesting that one of my clients told me. She grew up in Chennai, right now she's living in the US. She said that, you know, in Chennai there has been a practice of every Amavasya to eat roots, tubers and kacha bananas. And I was just thinking to myself that actually we do have a system of just recalibrating our hormonal balance every 15 to 20 days and every month by including all of these foods that we just spoke about into our diet, into our into our month so that there is diversity, there are better nutrients, and there is a variety of tastes and nutrients and prebiotics that our body can have access to. Let's not lose this to any fad. Let's not lose this to this mad rush of weight loss. Let's get good health first, and remember, weight loss follows. So all the best, follow this, and pain-free periods to all of you. Bye-bye.